It's time for another episode of Matt on the Streets with Matt Matach with Matt.
Hi, I'm Matt Matuszewski, and this is another installment of Matt on the Streets. And today, I want to show you what years of planning and months of hard work can accomplish along Rio Grande Street here in Littleton, Colorado.
The Rio Grande Bridge was installed in the late 1920s, when the world and the city of Littleton looked very different. Littleton's population was just over 2,000 people. The average price of a new car was $385, and the price of gas was 21 cents a gallon. The Rio Grande Street Bridge was determined to be structurally deficient and functionally obsolete. Replacement of the bridge was made a priority due to the proximity of the Littleton Police Department and South Metro Fire Station. An off-system bridge grant through the Colorado Department of Transportation was pursued and received to partially fund the project. The City of Littleton selected Bohan and Houston and AECOM to assist with the design process. This included modeling stormwater flows through the Slaughterhouse Gulch drainage basin that stretches to Broadway to the east, designing the proposed concrete box culverts, gas main relocation, a Denver Water distribution main replacement, structural supports for the concrete box culverts over the 60-inch Denver Water conduit, roadway design, landscaping, environmental, and historic features of the design. Prior to construction, a 6-inch XL gas main was relocated into deep bedrock to avoid any future conflicts with the proposed construction. Once American Civil Constructors was given the notice to proceed, route detours were posted and the bridge was closed to through traffic. First, the existing pedestrian bridge was relocated to Carbone Park for use in a future Lee Gulch crossing project currently being designed. Next, the existing utilities that were attached to the bridge were relocated or removed. This included a 10-inch Denver water main and a Lumen telecommunications line. Finally, the existing concrete and steel bridge deck and abutments were removed to make room for the proposed dual 10-foot by 12-foot concrete box culverts. Before the box culvert could be installed, piers were drilled on either side of the nearly century-old 60-inch Denver water conduit. These piers will transfer the load of the box culverts and roadway above directly into the bedrock, rather than through the Denver water conduit. The box culverts were then fabricated and installed with the use of one gigantic crane. Last but not least, the box culverts were backfilled, utilities and conduits placed, and the roadway was paved on top of the structure. This phase of the Slaughterhouse Gulch work is complete, and now the next phase of construction will begin in early 2023 with the installation of the Slaughterhouse Gulch Trail, which will connect Prince Street on the west to the Community Trail on the east, with a 10-foot wide paved multi-use trail. The northern cell of the Rio Grande Street Bridge and adjacent railroad box culvert will be used as the corridor for the new trail. This trail will connect northern Littleton residents to downtown and further to the Mary Carter Greenway.
Wow, that was a lot of work. It's great to see that we can use one city asset for so many different purposes. Take this project, for example. We were able to convey stormwater below, vehicles above, and in the future, we'll even be able to incorporate a multi-use path for pedestrians and bicyclists. It's projects like these that make Littleton such a vibrant place to live, work, and play. Thank you for joining me for another episode of Matt on the Streets. I hope to see you again soon. And if you have any questions, feel free to drop them into the email above. I think that was the best one.
Yeah.